I don't think any more perfect ballet exists than Giselle. The ballet is nearly 150 years old, and we still weep at the sweetness and the sorrowfulness of its story of villages and nobles, of love and passion, of innocence betrayed, of goodness gone astray. I am Anton Dolin. I was a dancer, choreographer, written many books, directed. I've been an actor all my life. And I learned the ballet Giselle when I was very young from great legendary ballerinas of our century. Its technical demands of virtuosity are really staggering. Giselle stands the supreme test for the classical ballerina.
Good, good. Don't break the wrist, sorry. Don't break the wrist. That's it. Now, this is a long hold of the arabesque. Patricia, tell me something, darling. Why, after a long, wonderful career, do you want to dance Giselle?
I've always loved the role of Giselle. It's a very feminine, a very deep role.
Hold it. Hold, hold, hold. Hold, hold, hold.
And I just would love to dance it.
No, you're going to.
Patricia McBride is a leading dancer with the New York City Ballet Company. Her partner on this occasion is Helgi Tomasson, born in Iceland and trained in Denmark.
I know that there is a photograph in Nijinsky and Karsavina where she is bent back. This Alonso does, it's unbelievable how she does it. Die, young. That's really Markova tempo, isn't it?
Largely because there is so much, so long a history behind me. I have drawn this portrait of Giselle in which each of these great artists contributes to the traditional canvas.
As though when you fall and on that fall, you fall on that arm. And when you get up,
each in her own way.
Into the feel in your shoulders. There. Alicia would finish it that way.
Bringing new insights.
I like it better when you come here. Now, get that on my
charming there. Details.
There. Just come, look. Just come, rush through him.
Enhancing it.
Rush.
This greatest of all romantic ballets.
Now go, Helen. Go, 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 go. Now, only when you see he's kneeling. I can't leave you. I can't.
The role that every now, classical ballerina dreams of dancing. Giselle.
Joseph Wishy presents A Portrait of Giselle with Sir Anton Dolin in conversation with Alicia Alonso, Yvette Chavire, Carla Fracci, Tamara Karsavina, Natalia Makarova, Dame Alicia Markova, Olga Spessivtseva, and Galina Ulanova.
Caught you. Hello, darling.
Hi.
How are you?
Hello. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Nice to see you, Helgi.
Hello.
I will just tell you just a few things, both of you, about Giselle. Giselle, with this score by Adolf Adam, was created in 1841 for Carlotta Grisi. She had been the mistress of Theophile Gautier, the librettist and French poet. And the choreographer, that was her husband, Harold. He created her steps. Jean Corrali, regisseur of the Paris Opera, created all the rest of the ballet. The story of Giselle is a romantic tale of innocent love and betrayal, of a philandering prince, Albrecht, and a trusting peasant maid, Giselle. Her beauty has entranced the nobly born Albrecht. It is the day of the great wine festival, and Albrecht, in order to court Giselle, disguises himself as a peasant. In fact, Albrecht is really engaged to the Princess Bathilde.
Albrecht's already changed. He's already out of his duke's costume. He's in a peasant costume. He's knocked at the door. Play the music. Now, Giselle opens the door. She's coming round the stage, looking everywhere for her Albrecht, dancing very happily.
Galina Ulanova was 47 when I first saw her dance in London. I'll never, never forget this remarkable dancer.
I thought her to be an honest, an innocent girl who delights in everything in nature, who believes that all people are truly kind.
A strange little girl, 15 years old in the original script. There's a lovely moment in Ulanova's Giselle where she's so shy when Albrecht takes her arm.
Come over to the chair and sit this way.
And I tried to teach all my Giselles these slight, very modest parts of the ballet.
No more than that, just the tiniest bit. Now, second time, take the dress, which is taking up the whole of the stool, and tuck it around you.
Giselle, in her innocence, resists Albrecht's advances only to succumb to his ardor and his persistence. He gently induces her to trust his pledge of eternal love and marriage.
Now, for the first time, you really are going to say something that you mean. Up to now, it's sort of playing around. Now, she's got her head, lift up her, look at her. Step. She doesn't believe it. You're used to being believed.
I think they always discuss about Albrecht being a cad. But I never felt he was.
No, I never felt either.
You see, it was because of the two circumstances. He had lived in the castle up on the hill. He had a much, shall we say, freer life.
There I am now, dancing with Markova. Alicia Markova, one of the greatest Giselles of all time. She first danced the role with me in London in 1934, the first English ballerina to dance the role. Whenever I played the role of Albrecht, I always felt rather puzzled.
You're a little bit puzzled.
You see, that's not the sort of game that we play at the palace. She loves me, she loves me not.
Yes. No. Oh, dear, it's not going to come out right.
Only afterwards, suddenly in my mind, I realize what she is doing.
She said to me, they are used to seeing only Marco as Giselle. You should not try to do it. In the first moment, your own idea or try anything new. You should try to follow to a certain extent the idea of her Giselle and then later work your own.
Alicia Alonso danced her first Giselle with me in 1943. Markova was ill, Alicia Alonso substituted. Markova was definitely the print from which she worked.
First act is about a part is joy and dancing is to feel when a young girl get in love and to feel a woman.
Scala Frati was the first 20th century Italian ballerina to gain an international reputation. Although frail, with a weak heart, Giselle has a passion for dancing.
This is, I think, what opportunity for a ballerina. You show also how you can act.
You are actually dancing
and acting at the same time. It's one of the very few ballets in which the dance is so important to the acting and the acting to the dance.
Now you walk on, and I'll give that a turn. You, and here's the old friend mine. You, please, stay here. And you say, no, 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 with the jetés. No, here. And you go up to the door, here, as she's doing it. Put your arm out. Now you run back. He stops you, duck under the right there. Oh, no.
Hilarion, a gamekeeper, in love with Giselle, discovers Albrecht's disguise.
There was only one reason why Giselle didn't care for Hilarion.
What is your reason for that?
I was told at the beginning because he had a red beard. He was a handsome, good-looking man, and would have provided very well for her.
But Giselle
didn't
like red hair.
That was why her mother had sympathy for Hilarion.
Albrecht's fiancée, the Princess Bathilde, arrives with her entourage for the village festivities. She herself is enchanted with Giselle and her innocence. Giselle tells Bathilde of her engagement, and Bathilde gives her a lovely necklace. Now, because of Giselle's weak heart, her mother dreads Giselle's passion for dancing. Don't do what I've seen so many times. When you come out of the house to your first entrance, you're already dying of consumption. You've already got a heart attack before you even started to dance. No, you're very carefree, you're very happy.
But she's very fragile.
She may be fragile in her health, but she is very gay, very happy to be alive.
Yvette Chavire, star of the Paris Opera, was my last Giselle.
I feel that the variation, the solo in the first act, is the culmination of Giselle's happiness.
You must not dance it like a great ballerina. There's none of that great Princess Aurora or the Swan Lake or Death Ordeal. No, it's simple.
Simple et noble.
Et noble. Et une grande danseuse.
Noble.
Noble and simple. But she is a peasant. It could be that she had some noble blood in her veins. You know very well that the nobles always like to dally with the peasant girls. That may be the reason why Albrecht is drawn to her.
She's all this life, ordinary life, all the dancing, peasant dancing, or conflict with Hilarion, and meeting with Bathilde, all this on life, it is actually, she's isolated from that.
Natasha Makarova brings to Giselle the brilliance of her Russian training and has become one of the greatest Giselles of her generation. This solo in Act One is one of the great moments of the ballet. Was never in the original score of Adam. It was first danced in London by Olga Spessivtzeva in 1932. It is now incorporated into every production of Giselle all over the world. Spessivtzeva's performance of Giselle has been a very great influence on nearly every present day dancer. She begs the mother to let her dance. Please, mother, let me dance. No. Please, let me dance. Oh, go on. I can't do anything about it. Go ahead. Go and dance. It's a joyous dance.
One, two, three, four. Down, up, up, up. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Da, 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 da.
The pleasure of loving, of being loved, of being surrounded by love. It is exactly at that moment when she is at her happiest that treachery strikes.
Valerian, now consumed with jealousy, reveals Albrecht's true identity and his engagement to the Princess Bathilde. Ends with the famous mad scene. I suppose really it's the balletic version of Lucia de Lammermoor. In those days, they used to love mad scenes in all the operas and ballets.
We're going to do the mad scene?
We're going to take from the moment where Giselle snatches off this lovely necklace that Bathilde's given her. Throws it at the feet of Albrecht. Throws it on the floor. Turns and falls right across the stage by her mother's feet. Hey, yum. The marvelous thing about Giselle and all the Giselles I have seen and danced with is that each dancer has her own personal interpretation, particularly of the mad scene. But all keep to the same notes. The frame of the Giselle must remain the same.
Engaged, and over there I picked a flower,
and near, now take up that flower, but don't look at it, turn it away, it is there in your hand, and over there I sat, over here, now there's a seat here, now you imagine the flower that you have in your hand, one,
Now your hands are getting cold. Cold. Oh. You come right back. Turn on the board. Now turn.
Apart that she has problem with the heart, but when she become crazy, it's because she's crazy and she die for love.
She's beyond this.
She's beyond it, yes.
This ordinary life.
But she's gone beyond the ordinary life in the second act.
Yes, but she already, for me, she's already in the first act. She has her own madness, own love, own being, own existence.
Yeah.
What is going on the second act?
Now we come to Act Two. Giselle has been buried deep in the forest. She has now become a Willy. The Willies are mysterious phantoms of folklore. Girls who died betrayed by faithless lovers on the eve of their wedding.
Mirtha, queen of the Willies, is sceptered with a magic wand. Its power summons the maidens from the dead. They haunt the dark forests at night, luring wayfarers into dancing with them until they die from exhaustion before the dawn arrives.
Mirtha, the queen of the Willies, commands Giselle to come from her grave to dance. She bows. Giselle is touched by the wand of Mirtha. She dances. Albrecht, full of remorse, comes to mourn at the tomb of Giselle, and it is she who is commanded by Mirtha to dance him to death. Actually, his is the difficult act, the second act, because he has a lot of dancing, Albrecht. He has to act as somebody being very exhausted, and it's all because of you that he's so exhausted. And then suddenly he's got to pull himself together and be very strong and lift you all over the place. The second act of Giselle is one long pas de deux. It is a Romeo and Juliet. It's a Tristan and Isolde of the dance.
And the bravura and the technique doesn't have to be shown. You jump, but you have to be in the air.
Shrug them away, and try. Now you do the devil there. You never take your eyes from him, he never takes his eyes from you, even when you're in the wings. That is so important. Catch him with one hand if you can. I can't do it anymore. I used to do it always. One hand. Thank you.
The first time I did those lifts was actually with Yvette Chavire. She particularly asked for them to be put back into the ballet at that time. They were cut in the score Sergeyev originally used for Spessivtzeva and myself in 32 and later with Markova. With Markova, we never did them. It's only in the later years of this great ballet that this pas de deux has become an acrobatic trick.
Adagio with Albrecht, it is so much in contact with him all the time. It's quite seductive.
Dance itself is the essential element of the plot. In the first act, Giselle's passion for dancing contributes to her death. In the second act, dance is the instrument of the Willy's power. Giselle saves Albrecht by dancing for him. It is this use of dance throughout the ballet that makes Giselle unique. Continues her dancing through the night until the dawn, as commanded by the Queen of the Willies. Although she has been betrayed, Giselle still loves Albrecht, and she entices him to keep dancing so that he may live. If he lives until the dawn, the power of the Willies is over, and they can no longer destroy him. The dawn has arrived, and now the power of the Willies is no more. My last Giselle with Yvette Chavire in London in 1959. Her great quality as a ballerina was honesty. Everything that she did was real. There was no camouflage and there were no tricks.
One must completely forget that one is watching somebody dance. One should see only Giselle. One should live the story through the person on the stage. But you should not be aware that she is doing an arabesque or an entrechat. That would destroy everything. And little by little, I worked until I found the truth. By thinking deeply about the character. And from the realistic aspect of the first act to the ethereal quality of the second, I feel truly on a different level of being. And I felt it each time. I was no longer Chavire, no longer at the opera. I was not even aware that I was dancing Giselle. It's very special. I also worked a great deal on the placing of the steps. When there are simply walking steps before beginning the dancing again, that's where one sees it.
The steps of the ballet that are important, but it's what you do going to those steps.
You cannot mime the wonderful scenes in Spectre with your feet beautifully pointed, walking with them. No, it's simple. It's there when you're doing the same thing here with Giselle. Don't walk with music. You want to feel that, the music. Don't walk with music. Just go on walking. Walk.
Je me suis aperçu que les pieds
I noticed
des danseuses étaient des choses monstrueuses.
The dancers' feet were monstrous.
Car les pieds des danseuses, lorsqu'ils sont sur
dancers
la pointe,
feet are on
sont
point,
deep.
They are divine.
Dès qu'ils sont à plat,
when they are flat, they are monstrous.
Alors, il faut... Moi, je me souviens des pieds de Markova,
I remember the feet of Markova. They were divine. Her hands and her feet were lovely. In the second act, the feet must not be human.
Charnel. Très travaillé.
It needs a great deal of work.
I'm sure you worked on it very hard, but it never showed that you worked hard.
It's not easy. J'ai eu des moments absolument exceptionnels.
I experienced it particularly in the second act. Truly a special state, a spiritual state, and I felt completely carried away.
I think I remember the first time you came to London.
The first time with the ballet.
The première fois, because
ballet
de
Monte Carlo.
Cambridge Theatre.
1946. Mm-hmm. It is a really souvenir. It's strange because we have the costume very short because. Economic, I said, situation.
Well, the war economic. Didn't on, you couldn't buy the tarlatan or the tulle.
No money. And all the costumes are so short because we have no money. No, it's all right.
That didn't matter for you because you have
beautiful. Terrible. But Madame Volkova came to the audience and she came after the performance. It for me is a souvenir fantastic. She told me, Yvette, I am so happy. You are the true Giselle. After Olga Spessivtzeva, you are the true Giselle. I am so I feel completely, comment dit-on, emotionated.
You feel very emotional. But there couldn't be a more beautiful compliment than to say, after Olga Spessivtzeva, you are the true Giselle.
Imagine.
Olga Spessivtzeva was a soloist with the Mariinsky Ballet in St. Petersburg. A
goddess of ballet who possessed the infinity of space when she danced. She danced the acting, acted the dancing. She brought naturalism under the sway of technique. Giselle became not a convention inherited from the past, but a story and a style good for any day.
Actually, I learned the role of Albrecht completely from Olga Spessivtzeva herself. And I remember her always telling me so many little points of Giselle, and so many of them we incorporated together.
Yeah.
The moment I think that is very poignant is when for a moment he does forget that he's a peasant, and he's sort of knocking her arm.
Now you forget for the moment you're being a nobleman, and you put your hand here, and you look at him. There, and you look. You want my hand?
Why?
Now you're going to kiss it, and you throw it away.
Yes.
Oh, no. Then you run away to the house.
Hello, elle était très étonnée. C'est une charmante geste.
Yes, it is charming. It's because of Spessivtzeva that we kept it here as part of our tradition.
For me, Spessivtzeva is like an ideal spirit, because from having my picture in my head from Russian Museum, Ballet Museum, this photo. Nothing can be more perfect, more beautiful.
Giselle, I don't like dance.
But the second act was lovely, wasn't it?
Yes. Second act, difficult.
Very difficult.
Yes, after I am dance only 6 months.
Yeah.
After 6 months, I am liberated.
You were free?
Yes.
Olga worked incessantly on her technique. She took classes and followed exhausting schedules of rigorous dance exercises. She was never satisfied. Perfection was what she was after. She paid the price for this submersion of herself, a retreat into madness where life was as much theater as was the stage. I had the great privilege to dance my very first Albrecht in 1932 with this great artist on my left. Olga Spessivtzeva. John Gilpin, star of London's Festival Ballet, was with me.
Olga, you remember when you taught me Giselle in London?
Yes.
I came from Berlin.
Yes. I don't know where she come. I know I dance with you.
You dance with me, and you taught me the role.
Yes.
Because you remember Sergeyev, our ballet master, he was so busy with the corps de ballet,
yes,
that he had no time to teach me, so you taught me.
Yes, I can professor, your professor.
I saw a film of you at the library with Spessivtzeva, a very beautiful part of the first act.
First act. Tiny little bit of film.
Incredible. Yeah.
That was done actually in 1932 at the Savoy Theatre in London, the very first time I ever danced with Spessivtzeva.
This is the only film that exists of Olga, the only record. Even with the poor quality of this amateur film as it was, you can still see how extraordinary Olga Spessivtzeva was. Now I join her. The costume, incidentally, that I was wearing was lent me by Dondre, who was really the common-law husband of Anna Pavlova.
She was lovely, really, to dance with. I adored her.
Did you like dancing with me, Giselle? I wasn't the bad partner.
You would like to dance?
I like to dance, but I like to dance with you.
I don't know. It's me, one or you, everybody.
But you were one of the most beautiful dancers in the world.
Yes, sir. Because of the revolution.
Because of the revolution?
Yes, and the Russian. Because, you know, I am finished in 1913.
Yeah.
After 1914, it commands guerre.
The war?
War.
The war?
Yeah. 1966, I am attending the American dance avec Nijinsky.
But you didn't dance Giselle with Nijinsky, did you, in America?
No, no.
What did you dance with him in America?
Spectre Rose.
Spectre de la Rose?
Yes.
Did you dance Sylphide with him?
Sylphide, yes.
Tell me, who was your first Albrecht?
Abukov.
Abukov?
Yes.
In Russia?
Yes.
Who was your teacher?
Legat, I work in the Legat.
Nicholas Legat was a dancer and teacher of the Imperial Ballet.
Preobrazhenska, same time, work in the Legat.
Preobrazhenska was another great ballerina of her time.
Vaganova, same time, in the me, work in the Legat.
Vaganova was a first soloist of the company, who later became a very great teacher. Altogether, you were...
Yes. Vaganova, Preobrazhenska, me, some three people work in the Legat.
You danced a great deal with Liffard, didn't you, Giselle, in Paris, at the opera?
Paris and Liffard.
Did you like dancing with him?
Yes, he's not bad.
Not bad?
No.
But not good either?
Yes, sir.
You know, I saw Serge dance with you, Giselle, in Paris, at the Paris opera.
Yes.
I think that was really when the first time I fell in love with you.
Paris, I dance much.
You dance, but not many times, so yes, many times, Giselle.
Many?
Yes. One after other, I am tired.
Tired?
Yeah. But after this, I'm not like much to Giselle.
To do Giselle.
Yes.
You dance so many times in Paris.
Yes.
Tell me something. The first time when you came to London and you danced Giselle at the Savoy Theatre, you brought with you a piece of music, manuscript, which was the solo of the first act. Was that your particular solo? Because it doesn't belong in the real score of Adam.
Yes.
It was yours?
Yes. My solo.
The composer of this solo has never been definitely identified, although many believe it was Leon Minkus. Olga was famous for her perfect technique, especially suited to Giselle. On this finger, one, and two, and three. Now, rendez-vous, renversé, taron. Now this way. Yeah. Then you this way, then here, then come forward. One, two, three. Alicia Alonso takes this variation remarkably slowly. There is a very good reason for that. You see, Alicia at that time was almost blind, and she had to take a very careful preparation for the two turns in attitude. Thank you.
the ballerinas dance that solo that you danced for the first time in 1932.
I remember the meeting was at La Scala to rehearse. The first thing that you told me to do was arabesque, and I did with you, and you were partnered me, and you said, you will be a wonderful Giselle. You remind me a lot of Spessivtzeva.
You do.
Fracci was trained at La Scala Theatre in Milano, Italy, as was Carlotta Grisi a century earlier. In 1841, Grisi captivated Parisian audiences with her new ballet, Giselle. By 1865, it vanished from the repertoire in France. It was kept alive in Russia, and 45 years later, Giselle was returned to Paris by Serge de Diaghilev. But you know, I tell you a secret, I don't know if he ever told you.
Yes.
One reason when in 1928-29 yes. I came back to the Diaghilev Ballet because he told me Patrick or baby, he never called me anything but Patrick or baby, next year I'm going to revive Giselle and Olga Spessivtzeva will be dancing it and you will dance Albrecht. And I never knew anything about Giselle at that time.
Yes.
And then he died before it came true.
I first danced with the Diaghilev Ballet Company at the Alhambra Theatre in 1921, the famous Bach's production of The Sleeping Beauty. I remember Diaghilev telling me many years later, he and Bach's were watching the final dress rehearsal.
And Diaghilev asked Bach's, Leon, who are the most beautiful things on that stage?
Yes.
And do you know what Bach's replied?
Yes.
Olga Spessivtzeva and the little boy with brown eyes. I was the little boy with brown eyes.
Yes.
I first danced with the Diaghilev Ballet Company at the Alhambra Theatre in 1921, the famous Bach's production of The Sleeping Beauty. I remember Diaghilev telling me many years later, he and Bach's were watching the final dress rehearsal.
And Diaghilev asked Bach's, Leon, who are the most beautiful things on that stage?
Yes.
And do you know what Bach's replied?
Yes.
Olga Spessivtzeva and the little boy with brown eyes. I was the little boy with brown eyes.
Yes.
Diaghilev was nicknamed Chinchilla because of the gray streak in his black hair. He was not a success at singing nor composing. He was not a bad pianist. But his worldly genius began a new era in the world of art. Diaghilev organized in Russia a great company of dancers, and he brought them to Western Europe for the first time. Great painters, designers, like Bakst and Benoit. Benoit actually designed set and costumes for Giselle. They don't exist today, but they're still there in the actual maquettes. Bach designed the costume, but only the costume for Anna Pavlova, for her production of Giselle. Pavlova was a very great dancer of Giselle. She danced it for the first time in 1903 in Russia.
In Russia, there were only really two dancers dancing Giselle. Anna Pavlova and Tamara Karsavina.
You know, the last time I saw Tamara, she spoke about you and asked how you were.
Yes, and I said, a lovely woman.
You loved her very much, didn't
yes.
you?
Come, woman, the best dancers.
As a woman, she was the best dancer?
No, the best woman.
Best woman.
Karsavina created many of the roles of Diaghilev's repertoire. The good-humored ladies, Coque d'Or, Les Sylphides, Spectre de la Rose, Firebird, Pulcinella, and many, many other ballets. Of all the Giselles that I interviewed, Tamara Karsavina was the only one that I never saw dance. Giselle. And I always remember her telling me, you know, Pat, she called me, that incidentally is my real name, so when they call you, I get rather confused that they want you or me. But she said, you know, Pat, Giselle to me always was a holy ballet.
Darling, will you tell us about the time you danced Giselle? What was the ballet called in those days?
Well, it was called a blessed ballet, or even holy ballet. And it was usually given to dancers with a great elevation.
You had to jump all the time.
You had to jump. It was a rather special thing in Giselle, that all the mime scenes were done together with dancing movements. So it was like acting.
Oh, dash it, it's not going to come out right. Wait, now pick up a flower, look at it. One, two, throw it away, that's it. Now, look. Yes, yes, yeah. Da, da, da. Ba, 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 ba. I think probably is the only really good male role, isn't it, for a dancer? Because you can act and you can dance.
Yes.
You don't just have to stand behind the ballerina all the time like a cardboard lugger, you know.
Nijinsky was one of the greatest Albrechts of all time. By the many photographs, we can easily imagine the sensitivity and depth that he brought to the role.
When did you first dance it with Nijinsky?
Oh, it was in 1910.
That was in Paris?
No, in Petersburg.
In Petersburg, in 1910?
Yes.
Was that, how many years had he been on the stage? I think only 1 year, wasn't it?
Only 1 year.
Was Nijinsky a good partner?
Yes, he was. He was strong, but a little bit too short for him.
Was he about the same height as me?
Oh, no, much less.
Much less than me?
Much less. He was much more comfortable to dance with.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. What was he like?
He was very docile and much liked by everybody.
He was not a first dancer, was he then? Didn't he have the rank of a soloist?
Yes, I think he had the rank of, might have been qualified or soloist.
But you had you were then still the rank of a ballerina.
Not yet.
Not yet?
When you first... Not all the time. Oh, perhaps I was.
I think...
Yes, I was the ballerina.
You were
the
ballerina. Wasn't there a little scandal attached to Nijinsky in his costume?
Yes, unpleasantness.
He wasn't dressed properly, yes?
He had the costume designed by Benoit. And it consisted of tight and the very short jacket. And usually the men wore...
A little slip over the tights.
A little slip over the tights. He refused to put that.
Little trousers?
Yes.
Yeah.
But next morning, there was officially his dismissal from the ballet. But Nijinsky really was very pleased because he was entirely, then he belonged to Diaghilev.
What happened once when the strap on your corsage...
Oh, yes. My corsage got undone. The shoulder showed a bit. And I had to pull it back all right.
Yeah.
And after their performance, Pavlo rushed to me, very furious.
Anna Pavlo.
And she said I was indecent and many other harsh words. So, naturally, I cried.
Oh. Was Preobrazhenskaya there at that time?
Yes. Preobrazhenskaya was a ballerina.
Yes.
And he came over to me saying, I danced very well, and my pirouettes were a real pleasure to him. Well, that consoled me a bit.
Don't you think she was a kinder person than Krasinska?
Well, Krasinska was very kind to me.
She was?
She was, when she wasn't going against.
Matilda Krasinska, of course, could have danced any role that she wanted. After all, she was the favorite of the Tsar of Russia. And Diaghilev, how was Diaghilev's reaction?
Diaghilev was very kind to me. And afterwards, we had a very great friendship.
Well, he loved you very much, Diaghilev.
Yes, he did.
Don't you feel that today there are too many dancers who want to dance Giselle that are unsuited to that role?
Oh, yes.
Because it's a very special role.
Oh, yes.
I mean, it demands so much. Well, you had it.
Yes, it demands lightness.
She was very sweet about one story that she told me also. When Vaganova, she said, you know, Madame Vaganova, of course, I have big respect for her, you know, she was a great, great teacher. And one day she came and I understood that my performance of Giselle was going to be given to her. Of course, I was very, very upset, you know, because we didn't have everyday performances of Giselle, and this was one ballet I loved so much. Really, she was not quite for Giselle Vaganova. Great teacher, great dancer, I must tell you, she was complete disaster. I was very happy. That's Karsavina.
I had two ambitions in my life. One was to be the first dancer of the Diaghilev Ballet, and the other was one day to dance with Tamara Karsavina. And I did both.
And you did both.
Yes.
A beautiful lady.
Beautiful lady.
That's what Diaghilev always called her, my dearest lady.
Yes.
A legend as great as the beautiful Karsavina is Galina Ulanova. She was born in Petersburg in 1911 and became the renowned prima ballerina of the Bolshoi Ballet.
In the second act, I tried to present her as someone no longer lifelike, a spirit from another world, a creature that we find in legends. We have mermaids, other nations have bewitched foxes. All of them lure human beings into dancing with them and eventually destroy them.
Galina Ulanova danced the first time Giselle in London. After the performance, she asked me, which I thought was very interesting, she said, Anton, tell me something. You saw me dance Giselle tonight. How did my dancing, especially my first act, compare to Olga Spessivtzeva?
The
mother of Galina.
Galina.
Yeah.
Elle toujours prenait sa daughter looking me kind of.
Ah, she was she was always bringing her daughter to see you dance.
Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm.
That was why then she asked
in,
me.
In St. Petersburg.
Yes, yes.
And that's the reason you see how she asked me. Because she said, how does my performance compare to Olga Spessivtzeva?
I didn't want to stress her ailment that is suggested in the first act. To the contrary, I wanted to present her as someone who is full of joy of living, so that the audience would not at once realize her handicap. At the end of the first act, there is a segment that is usually called a mad scene. In my opinion, it is not a mad scene. She does not become insane. She is so shaken by the faithlessness and betrayal perpetrated by her beloved that she loses control of her thoughts. I didn't feel it necessary to visit an asylum that cares for the insane and study them. Her senses leave her, and her senses return. First she recognizes her mother, and then him. And despite the harm he has done her, she reaches out for him, then dies.
And I said, you know, madame, looking at you in the first act, it was almost like looking at Olga Spessivtzeva.
But not the mad scene.
Ulanova's mad scene differs considerably from Olga Spessivtzeva's. Because Olga told me once that she really wanted to study people in the madhouse to prepare her for this final scene of Act One in Giselle. Look at the way she's walking. So right on the heel of the foot. Her mad scene was, I think, really one of the greatest of them all. Giselle took its toll. In 1941, Olga Spessivtzeva had a serious nervous breakdown.
I know that you don't like to talk about yourself, but it's very important that you do.
Yeah.
20 years later, she was cured. I brought her from the Poughkeepsie State Hospital to the Tolstoy Farm in Nyack. As we were driving there, I asked her, Olga, you remember that long sable fur coat that you owned? She said, well, of course, Anton, I remember. But do you think that after 20 years, the long sable coat will remember me?
I am comme folie quand je danse Giselle. Folie.
Mad.
So I would like to ask you what I can put into the role of myself.
Interpretation, which is really what you want to know about, that can be changed. After all, you have Joan Sutherland, you have Tebaldi, you have Maria Callas. They all sang the same operas. They always sang the same notes, but their interpretations were quite different.
Now, people would say, who did you copy? Who were you influenced by?
Dame Alicia Markova was only 14 when she joined the Diaghilev Company.
was quite extraordinary at such an early age.
I can go back to the very first time that I saw it. It was Covent Garden, the Opera House, and a matinee when Arnold's mother, Mrs. Haskell, took me to see Pavlova dance Giselle. I can almost see her now coming out of the grave in these chiffon draperies and a strange color of gray-green, very eerie. And it really made such an impression on me as this eerie, dramatic work. Now, that was my very first impression of the ballet. Then, of course, my next impression was the Camargo season, when the divine Spessivtzeva came to dance. When she finished the mad scene, the end of that first act, she never spoke a word. I used to put the shawl around her, and she used to nod, and I used to accompany her to her dressing room, and the door would close, and then I would wait for the second act, and I would sit, and an entirely different being would emerge, and I would sit enthralled until the end of the ballet. If you can imagine Pavlova and Spessivtzeva, both fantastic, great, but entirely different. Well, I am off today. I must try and just express my own feelings then about this ballet. When I first, shall I say, met Giselle, she was a very shy, innocent person who lived in that area that we saw when the curtain rose, and really had never, I don't think, been very much further away from that. So one could understand the tragedy. Now, I think the age we live in today, perhaps it's a little more difficult for people to understand that, because I think the word innocence is something people don't even children now, I don't think, seem to know the meaning of the word.
I know the last time we danced it ever together in England was at Golders Green Hippodrome.
Yes, but we did dance it together after that.
Yes,
we danced
in Paris. In Paris.
And also in Lisbon.
We danced it together probably more times than any other dancing couple since 1934, which was our first performance, 1st of January. We danced it all over America, all over England.
We danced it in France.
Didn't we dance it in Israel?
We danced it in Israel.
Do you remember
yes.
that tour yeah. when we
Do you remember? It's because we danced it in the open air in Israel, in Haifa.
Yes.
And I know you were worried, and I was very worried, about at the end of the first act, when you fall dead, how you were going to be got off the stage, because there was no curtain to close. It was fully light.
I was the first, actually, to put boys into the first act of Giselle, because I really could not see why the village should be only inhabited by a lot of girls, with only Hilaria and Albrecht having to take care of them all. You know, it's too much.
So we devised it together that you would be carried out by the peasant boys very slowly, in a very quite sort of religious way, if you like, to your dressing room. You loved it because for the first time you didn't have to walk.
I know, and then the other amusing thing, when I reached the dressing room, do you remember there was a scare because somebody said that there was a scorpion rushing around?
No, I didn't know that.
Do you know the reason?
What?
Why? You never knew these things before?
No.
Because we were always so very busy being Giselle and Albrecht. I think that we never had time to sit down like this and have a real chat about
it. That's right. You see, opportunity comes very late sometimes in life, but it does come, and it's very pleasant.
I feel like I live with Giselle all my life. It's been quite a long time when I danced for the first time.
Did you dance for the first time in Russia?
Well, I was prepared, but I think the first real performance what I give for the public, it was in London.
In London, yes.
1961.
The Royal Opera House?
Yes. Yes, and it was unexpected success for myself. I was shocked by that because I was 19, 20 years old. And it was a remarkable day for me, in my memory. My first Giselle and my first tooth coming out.
Takes the second act, pas de deux, as slowly as you take it.
You know, I have a special... It's come from me from a gear of training, because the phrasing of music, because we always have breathe before the phrase.
Mm-hmm.
Breath.
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 Sorry.
Breath. Oh, just you can say breathe is very nice.
I think it is come from, like... And one, not one,
yeah,
straight away.
Yeah, yeah. Very Russian training, very
yes,
Kirov training.
It's from the childhood when it's kids standing,
yeah, yeah.
Holding the bar and pour the bra first, not doing one, two thing. And one, and two. Yeah. So it's give you...
I don't know. You know who also taught
so,
that?
Excuse me, but I don't think I like especially slow. I just want this phrasing, you know. But actually, I have some extreme. If it's fast, I like very fast. If I slow, I like as slow as possible. Mm-hmm. Just probably to make body to sing.
That's body to sing, that's to a sing. Lovely expression.
Because otherwise I don't have time to extend my body, to fulfill the phrase. For me now is most important.
Yeah.
It just give the only essence of drama. So it shouldn't be too much fascinating. So if I, for example, before, if I have lots of shyness, you know, girl shyness, yeah. And when it's Albrecht stalked me, I did that and turned a lot. Now, if he touched me and I turn, so I look at him like that, straight and nice, without directly, everything more directly. Even before, if it's before, was the, all that pose, posing for the pose, beauty for beauty. Now I try to feeling inner feeling to come to that pose and still be with me in my own world, with my atmosphere, not to play too much out, but with me. But at the same time, I think it's get more projective. When the question of the, you know, of interpretation, what we always came for me before in Kirov days, what should I forgive Albrecht or not, or what? Now is no question, because she have only peace and wisdom, what is possibly be only beyond the ground,
beyond the grave.
So she have that now, and only think what she can do with her eternal femininity in her, forgive. And second act is, for me, it's mystical feeling is very strong. And I feel almost, I have to feel the present, this mystical atmosphere, almost physical. It is quite a feeling, try to release yourself from the flesh. For me, it's also a symbol of her soul, get freedom. I can change the coloring, I can change details, what it depends from my mood, but the general frame will remain the same now.
She's always kept in the framework of the ballet. She's never come out of it. It was here, where I'm talking to you in New York, that Lucia Chase asked me to do a production of Giselle. And it was then, for the first time, that I was able to really to incorporate into my production, all those years later, so many of the things that Diaghilev had told me in 1929.
So you've had a lot of different transitions in with Giselle.
A lot. But it's been interesting, too. With Yvette Chavire, there was always something a little bit different. We found something different in it.
Uh-huh.
Carla Fracci, who I first taught it to, also in the 50s, she never danced it with me. She danced her first performance and many performances with John Gilpin.
In the 19th century in Italy, there were three great Italian ballerinas: Maria Taglioni, Fanny Cerito, and Carlotta Grisi. When they died, really, the art of the ballet, in Italy particularly, went into a very sound sleep. In later years, the great legends of these three dancers has been resurrected by the great ballerina with whom I'm talking, Carla Fracci.
I don't deserve that. I
mean, oh, yes, you do.
I think it's a little bit too much.
Carla, I think you will remember the very first time you danced in London, Giselle. Your first partner was John Gilpin.
Right.
And you did the third Giselle that week in London in 59. The first was Alicia Markova with Skuratov. The second was the great French ballerina, Yvette Chavire, with me. And the third was you with Gilpin. The headline across the paper was, "The third Giselle is the best of all."
Yes.
You were wonderful.
Yes, yes. I was scared to death. I was 18, but you encouraged me and you gave me so much, which is really fantastic to have had this opportunity. All the newspaper was talking about this thing, and I went back.
What do you mean, this thing that we're talking about, Carla Fracci?
Well, the event that one Italian, una ballerina italiana,
si,
was going in London was incredible, you know. So I went back and I said, we should do, we must do Giselle at La Scala. And they said, oh, no, 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 no. For years I had to fight to have Giselle doing, yes, Giselle at La Scala, because music, awful. Ballet, oh, what is that? This crazy one that she got to die and, you know, oh, no, 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 old-fashioned drama, melodrama, you know. Sure. They didn't want, no one conductor wished to conduct, Giselle. So it's been really very hard. Now, you know, it's fantastic because all ballerina wants to do. And La Scala, doesn't matter how and which situation, they want to do Giselle.
Yeah.
You see, I adore Giselle. I think it's...
You are Giselle.
It's my favorite ballet. It's a jumping ballet and it's bravura there. And also the big adagio that she has. I mean, that is... It's difficult. It's really difficult. It's not easy ballet, and also the style, the tension, the emotional way that you dance. When I finished at Swan Lake, I was not so destroyed, I mean, as I am in Giselle. First of all, is the wish of life. This young girl, the joy of the life, the discover of the life, the discover of love, and the feeling to be a woman. I mean, I remember with Eric.
Eric Brun.
Eric Brun, which I've been dancing with him in New York the first time. Actually, he invited me. He decided to have me near him to dance Giselle. I cannot really explain. There are people that they meet immediately. They don't even need to talk. Is there really a love on stage? You don't need to talk. You don't need to fix things. I hate to say, you know, oh, I go there, and, you know, you stay here, you go to the bench, you know. It's how you feel, of course, the steps are there. But even if you change in the music, you are a little bit later, but it's what is important, how you look each other, how you touch. And I must say, every dancer has something to give you.
Oh, yeah.
And this brings, you know, such a richness. Because, well, you see, for example, Nureyev is such a power. He's so aggressive when he comes in.
Divine aggressive power.
It's fantastic. So he has these eyes that looks you, you know, and he goes inside you. So, of course, you have to react somehow, you know, but it's not maybe the way that I... My reaction is different than I was doing when I was doing it with Eric. I don't want to say that it's better. It's not important. It's the moment. That is important. It's what you create, and this creates the performance.
Thank you.
think when you find on stage that you arrive really to love him, which I think I must love, really. My partner.
You must give that
feeling. I love so many.
well, you're not Italian for nothing. But I think you must give that illusion, whether you really do love or not.
Yes.
You must cross the footlights.
That's it. That's it.
Been lovely talking to you.
I've seen many Giselles since I was a little girl.
In life or in film?
In life.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw Alonso when I was very young. I don't remember the steps exactly, but the feeling and how they looked.
You know, when Alonso did her first Giselle, it was at the old Metropolitan Opera House. And she knew that season that she was going to dance the role. So I taught it to Alonso, and she was quite extraordinary.
Alicia, tell us about those memories and that wonderful first performance, anyhow, for me, that you danced at the Metropolitan in New York in 1943.
I remember. I just came back to ballet theater after having two operations on my eyes. From detachment of the retina in New York. I spent a year in bed and 1 year getting myself in practice. I learned every role that I could see in Giselle. I learned the corps de ballet, the main roles, even the male's roles, the principal roles. So when I used to be in bed recovering from my eyesight, I used to go through my mind, through the whole ballet. And when I forgot something, I would do it with my hands and try to remember the style and the angle that it went. So when this opportunity came after I recovered from my eyesight and they asked me, I didn't even hesitate for 1 minute to say, yes, I will dance it. We rehearsed every day. I even forgotten that I haven't eaten all day long. And I remembered how patient you were every day working with me. Teaching me, rehearsing. And I remember seeing you doing all of it, including the part of the woman, of Giselle. And you even showed me in certain part of the match scene, certain things that you would have liked to see it different, but that I should not change it in the moment, but let myself grow into it.
Now, you go to the mother, run to mother, fall in her arms, here, for now. Now you get up. Now, this is what you do, look. Go over, you go to Albrecht. You, now this is the mind. You feel this afterwards in your own way. You will come to me when I am dead. And you fall.
Something that helped me later on very much, it was the making of the movie of Giselle. And when I made the movie, we made a very, very careful study of everything, every part. And we gave every member of the company the story of his person. One is the son of a man that works in the wood. And one of them is very close to Giselle. She helps make the dress for this festival, the day of the grapevine festival. It takes more time, it takes more work. But you must give them an idea. What are they doing? Who are they? Why of the gesture? Why when you express, especially in our big theaters today, that it's not enough that you just go like this, but when you want to say something, you must go with your whole body. It's the gesture of everything, an amplitude of movement.
Alicia Alonso was born in Havana. She studied in New York. Her partnership with Igor Yuskevich was legendary. She is considered one of the greatest Giselles of her generation. She founded and created the National Ballet of Cuba.
I was there for your 35th anniversary when you invited me to Cuba, and I had the honor of even coming on the stage and crowning you, as I did, with a wreath over your head.
Beautiful.
Wasn't it?
Oh,
I loved doing it.
Beautiful. You did?
Oh, I loved it. I remember Castro coming on the stage. He said to you, do you like this theater that you're dancing in? You said, no, I want my own theater. He said, right, in 2 years you will have your theater.
Because every day their children are born and they have the right to see masterpieces that we have inherited from our past.
But it must be vital still.
I think the best thing we have done is trying to keep the essence of the Romanticism.
But there again, one must move forward, you see.
Pauvin, to conquer the obstacles. It is the only way to make progress.
Giselle, I don't like dance.
Giselle is such a role.
It is difficult.
Yes, the man likeness.
And I think he will grow, I think. He's never stopped there because that is right and that I will not change.
I change, living through life. And my Giselle is changed.
Your experience allows you to bring something new each time you perform.
That's why it's remarkable, this ballet. It gives you freedom to interpret in different ways, in different nuances.
And maybe I will have to do all over again, because what I'm doing now, maybe I was all wrong. Who knows?
And the portrait of Giselle, and to all the dancers, I always say, don't think you know all of it. Keep searching till you find yourself.
Honestly, it's taken me years to learn it, but now when you do know the actual movement of it, now feel it in your own way. Very big entrechassis. Yeah. And this is long. Not too slow, Martha.